Hi, this is Debbie at Deb Scraps YouTube channel. I'm happy to be here today because I'm in Kansas and I'm with my best scrapbooking bud ever, Terry. And I had noticed a trend on Pinterest and on YouTube where people were making things out of Sharpies and rubbing alcohol. And it's 91% rubbing alcohol. They said that was important not to get the lesser strength. And then we put it in a spray bottle. So we didn't want to try it on just anything. We wanted to see if we could use this in scrapbooking. So first, let me show you what we did. And then we're going to try, while we're on here, show you how this will turn out. So the first thing we did, I had bought some heavyweight paper. It was 140 pound paper, and I was trying to do tie-dye, and then we put the markers on and I sprayed the rubbing alcohol, and it didn't do too well. We kind of noticed that the outer colors would run a little bit, but the inner colors didn't really smear. Terry did have a little more luck when she like brushed it around with her finger, and then like we rubbed it with a napkin. And so then we used just regular scrapbook paper. That's not what we call it. What do we call it?
Cardstock.
Cardstock. That's the word I was looking for. And about the same result. As you can see, like the outer color kind of, we got it to run, but not the inner colors. And it did kind of bleed together a little bit, but just not how we liked it. So then we were seeing how it would do on photo paper. And first we used the non-shiny side and about the same, and then the shiny side, and it did run a little more, but not how we wanted. And finally, we just used regular printer paper, and Terry printed on it, I mean marked with a Sharpie, squirted on this side with the rubbing alcohol, and then she folded the paper and started rubbing it and pressing down. And it was actually closer to the effect that we wanted to start with. It bled through. So you'd have to have probably the thinner paper in order to bleed through. And so now I made a rainbow. And this is on regular cardstock. And Terry is going to squirt it with the rubbing alcohol. And we're trying to show you how it is running there. And I tried to make it so that since it seemed the outer layers tend to run, I tried to make it so that maybe we'd have some dripping down on the edges there, like right there. It's actually the best we've had, I think. But it's not really tie-dye, but the rainbow kind of does look cool. So that is like on regular cardstock. Now, if we rubbed it with our finger, Terry's sacrificing her finger for the cause, it does smear a little bit more and blend it. Looks like our skies have been in Kansas lately, downpours, and it's been rainy since I've been here, but it's been really cool. And then we've been taking the like a napkin and rubbing, and it kind of does that, kind of blends them together a little bit too. One other thing Terry and I did, this was Terry's idea. I'll get up. Oh, look on the towel. We have a rainbow. We'll just do it on this paper. We colored some colors. Just, you want to do a color, a couple of them? And then we sprayed the rubbing alcohol, and then we blew on it with a straw, and you could see it somewhat. I wouldn't consider this a failure, but it wasn't the success that I hoped for. And that's what, and it did kind of blow it out. Oh, there. That's kind of, you can see the edges, and that does look pretty. So, that is what we have. I wanted to share it with you because I was curious, so I knew there would be other people that was curious. Thank you for joining me today, and please feel free to like and subscribe. See you next time.